Metformin is a diabetic medication that is part of the biguanide class of drugs. As the first-line therapy for type 2 diabetes, metformin notably decreases hepatic gluconeogenesis, increases glucose uptake, and increases glucose breakdown. In this video, I'll walk you through my visual mnemonic to remember metformin's clinical use and toxic side effects. Let's get started. First, notice this construction foreman in the center of our scene here. For those of you who aren't familiar with foremen, they're the first-line supervisors in charge of an entire construction crew. Geez, that's a lot of responsibility on one person's shoulders, but our foreman here is up for the job. He's pretty well qualified, you know. In typical foreman fashion, he's trying to get his workers back to work after their lunch break. We'll get back to how he's doing that in a second, but for now, just remember this foreman to peg the drug, metformin. Foreman for metformin. Get it? Next, notice this big gong that our foreman is ringing. Yeah, he's ringing this big gong to get his workers back to work. Why a gong and not some normal clock? We'll find out in a bit. For now, notice how the phrase big gong sounds a lot like biguanides or biguanides. Yeah, this big gong is here to help you remember that metformin is a drug in the class of biguanides because big gong sounds like biguanide, right? So it's the end of lunch, but what were our workers eating anyways? Take a look at this construction worker in the back here. He looks pretty nauseated, clutching his stomach and stuff. I wouldn't want to be in his place. Anyways, he's nauseated because of what he had for lunch. A ton of cookie dough. I mean, just look at the cookies he's making. I love cookie dough, but I would probably get sick if I had as much to eat as he did. Our worker's nausea is here to help you remember that one of the most common side effects associated with metformin use is GI upset, which includes nausea, abdominal discomfort, and diarrhea. While we're here, I also want to mention that metformin use is not associated with weight gain. Maybe these are low-fat cookies? Oh, so that's why he's not feeling well. I hate low-fat cookies too. Next, notice how our nauseated construction worker has spilled his cookie mix. If sweet, sugary cookies represent glucose, then cookie mix must represent the production of glucose, otherwise known as gluconeogenesis. This cookie dough is also coincidentally shaped like a liver, which helps me remember that gluconeogenesis takes place in the liver. You see, metformin decreases hepatic gluconeogenesis, thereby decreasing the body's ability to make more glucose. The exact mechanism is unclear, but it is speculated that metformin activates adenosine monophosphate kinase, also known as AMPK. AMPK activation in turn inhibits mitochondrial glycerophosphate dehydrogenase, as well as complex 1 of the electron transport chain, thereby leading to decreased ATP formation and decreased hepatic gluconeogenesis. Don't worry so much about the mechanism here. It's still a research topic and probably won't show up on your exam. Instead, just remember that metformin causes decreased hepatic gluconeogenesis. If you had diabetes or high blood sugar, you'd want to decrease glucose production too, right? Another one of metformin's mechanisms of action is increasing glycolysis. Take a look at the burning sugar cookies in the oven behind our nauseated construction worker. Yep, these cookies are definitely on fire, maybe because our nauseated worker isn't paying attention. Anyways, these fiery cookies are here to help you remember increased glycolysis of sugar, since glycolysis burns or uses up sugar, right? Metformin leads to increased glycolysis in cells, which uses up sugar, so that there's less glucose left in the serum. Makes sense, right? Now, take a look at this other worker in the foreground here. It looks like he really likes these cookies. Now that lunch is over, he's even sneaking some cookies out. We'll call him our sugar cookie thief. By the way, this worker is taking up these cookies, which makes me think of peripheral glucose uptake. Get it? taking up cookies for increased glucose uptake? And you guessed it, metformin increases peripheral glucose uptake. It mediates this increased glucose uptake by increasing insulin sensitivity, since insulin normally stimulates cells to take up glucose. Recall how patients with type 2 diabetes are insulin resistant. So any drug that can make them more sensitive to insulin is A-okay. This is part of the reason why metformin is the first-line drug for type 2 diabetics. Yay, metformin! Next, notice what this worker is taking along with his cookie for later. Yep, it's a glass of milk. I dare you to name a more classic combination than milk and cookies. By the way, this milk makes me think of lactic acidosis, since milk is our recurring symbol for lactate. It's the lactate milk, right? Anyways, lactic acidosis is one of the toxic side effects of metformin. The mechanism of metformin's induction of lactic acidosis is pretty complicated, so just know that lactic acidosis is a potential side effect of metformin use. But take a closer look at how our worker is sneaking out this milk. Yeah, he's pouring it into this flask that's shaped like a kidney? Yeah, it's a kidney. This kidney-shaped carton is here to help you remember that metformin is contraindicated in kidney failure. This is related to the lactic acidosis we just mentioned. The kidneys play a role in clearing acid and lactate from the blood, so I like to think that impaired kidneys can cause accumulation of lactate. And since metformin causes increased production of lactate, patients with kidney failure are at a higher risk of developing lactic acidosis. Therefore, it's good practice to check kidney function prior to prescribing metformin for type 2 diabetics. Finally, take a look at our cobalt blue clock in the background. Now we know why our construction foreman has been using a big old gong in the first place. It turns out that our regular clock has been broken for some time, and that our foreman needed a new way to get the workers back a-workin'. Anyways, notice how our clock hands are pointing right at 12. A cobalt blue clock pointing to 12 makes me think of cobalamin, also known as vitamin B12, because it's a B12 o'clock. Get it? This B12 clock is here to help you remember vitamin B12 deficiency, another potential side effect of metformin use. The mechanism here is unclear, so just remember this broken cobalt clock at 12 to peg vitamin B12 deficiency on test day. All right, I'm really full after eating all those sugar cookies. Let's do a quick recap and then get back to work. Metformin is the first-line therapeutic drug used for type 2 diabetes. A drug in the biguanide class, metformin controls blood sugar in several ways. These include decreasing hepatic gluconeogenesis, increasing glycolysis, and increasing peripheral glucose uptake and insulin sensitivity. Notably, metformin can increase production of lactate in the body, leading to lactic acidosis. This is particularly common in patients with impaired kidney function, which is why metformin is contraindicated in renal failure. Other side effects to note are GI upset and vitamin B12 deficiency. Well, that about wraps up this video on metformin. I've got to get back to building, you know, building more study materials for all you guys out there. Until next time.
Thanks for watching. For more videos like this one, click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also support our team by visiting Pixorize.com, where you'll find exclusive videos and interactive review images. If you like what we're doing, share with your friends on social media, and we'll keep making great content like this. We'll see you next time.